Although we are going to focus on value stream mapping, lead time is one of the foundational concepts underlying many of the lean tools. In layman's terms, lead time is the answer to your customer's most fundamental question, when can I have it? Let's start our discussion with the concept of process lead time, a concept that can be confusing even to seasoned lean practitioners. Normally, process lead time is simply calculated by converting the unit of measure for cycle time from its usual seconds or minutes into some tiny fraction of one day. But there are times when you want to override your process lead time with a much longer time than cycle time. For instance, you might have curing or drying or fermenting or something going on that takes a long time. You don't have a person standing there working on it all that time, but the process takes a long time, much longer than the cycle time. So when we scroll down here to the time sum line, notice that the total lead time is the sum of the lead time within the processes plus the totals for all of the lead times between processes. Okay, let's fast forward a few years and look at a more recent version of a value stream map and notice that the lead time between processes is now called queue time. And when you first get started with an as-is value stream map, you usually just fill in a really rough and dirty number in this override field just to the left. Remember that the two columns that always need to be hidden and unhidden and always need to stay together are the primary process box and then the between process boxes just to its right. So we're going to enter our override data in the cell just to the left. That way those two columns always stay associated. And we always enter our data in working days. And that way if we use our lead time unit of measure converter to switch to calendar days, hours, or weeks, then that light gray cell to the left still stays consistent in working days. So that's how you override it with a guess to get started. But once you get good at this, you will let it auto-calculate the amount of queue time by entering in the amount of your standard work in process inventory. Let's say you typically had 100 units of inventory lying around in between these two processes. It calculates your queue time by multiplying the tack time, which happens to be 2 minutes, times the amount of inventory, which turns out to be a quarter of it or an eighth of a day here. Or if you had 1,000 units, that means that stuff must sit around in between these two processes for an average of a day and a quarter. And again, if that simple tack time calculation isn't quite accurate for every process, you can always override it. Thank you for trusting Systems to Win to help you continuously improve your tools for continuous improvement.